Missionaries who described it in the 1700s claimed it serves for mystification and bewitchment. But the origins of this botanical beverage trace back much further to the earliest indigenous inhabitants of the Amazon basin. Today, it's a trendy trip in mainstream drug culture, but also a promising key for unlocking new potential of the brain and mind. This is Ayahuasca.
Hi, I'm Tasha the Amazon, and you're watching Floralogic. While most people treat ayahuasca as just another trip, it's actually been used as a powerful medicine for probably over 10,000 years, or as long as humans have inhabited the Amazon basin.
Ayahuasca is an entheogen, which means it's a psychoactive substance that is used in a sacred or traditional context. Other examples of entheogens are peyote and magic mushrooms. Traditionally, ayahuasca is administered under the close care of a shaman and is used as a medicine to correct physical, emotional, and spiritual imbalances and encourage more harmonious relationships with others.
When the warriors of Amazon tribes returned from hunting, for example, they drank ayahuasca to process the aggression of the hunt and help them reintegrate into the community.
Through the experience of ingesting ayahuasca, the drinker is meant to connect deeply with their inner self and gain direct access to the spiritual world. Ayahuasca, after all, is a Quechua word that can be loosely translated to vine of the soul or vine of the spirits.
Ayahuasca itself isn't technically a single plant. It's a psychotropic tea made of two plants, the vine, Banisteriopsis caapi, and the shrub, Psychotria viridis. Other plants can be added, but these two are the main attractions. Let's break down each of these plants individually.
First up is Banisteriopsis caapi, sometimes called yaje or just plain caapi. This plant is a liana, a giant woody-stemmed vine native to the Amazon and Orinoco river basins in South America. It's one of about 16,000 members of the Malpighiales order, one of the largest orders of flowering plants. This evergreen climber can reach up to 30 meters long.
That's as long as the longest blue whale ever recorded.
There's some speculation that Amazonian shamans first became aware of the powerful effects of Banisteriopsis caapi when they observed jaguars tripping bippity-boppity-boos after gnawing on these vines.
It's the jungle equivalent of catnip, but for big old cats.
Next up is Psychotria viridis. Commonly called chacruna, this plant is a flowering shrub that's part of Rubiaceae, otherwise known as the coffee family. This woody plant is no shrimpy shrub. It can grow 5 meters tall and 2 meters wide. In addition to being a key ingredient in ayahuasca, the Machiganga people also use the juice of its leaf as eye drops to treat migraines.
It burns like hell when you first drop it in your eyes, but it gives you access to heightened vision to see with understanding, according to the Andoke tribe of Colombia.
Ayahuasca is made by a shaman by washing pieces of caapi bark, pounding them with a wooden mallet, and layering them with washed leaves of Psychotria viridis in a large pot. The pot is filled with water to cover the plant matter and boiled for at least 8 hours to concentrate it.
So what happens when someone takes ayahuasca? In Spanish, the effect is referred to as mareación, which means dizziness. The drinker may experience visual hallucinations, a sensation of flying, and a sense of euphoria.
Taking ayahuasca over a long period, they may also see their friends and family, both dead and alive, and feel that they can communicate with them. Along with the more pleasant effects, usually also come clumsiness, vomiting and diarrhea, and sometimes also fear, paranoia, and aggression.
To most, puking and pooping your pants may not seem like a fun trip, but for some cultures, the purgative properties of ayahuasca are a welcome part of the experience. Followers of the Santo Daime religion view the puke and the poop that come out as repressed emotions leaving the body.
Caapi and Psychotria viridis grow in the same regions of South America and are seemingly made for each other. The chemicals in these two ayahuasca plants work in perfect harmony to enable the drinker to have a deep, psychotropic experience. The three main harmala alkaloids found in caapi, harmine, tetrahydroharmine, and harmaline, produce psychoactive effects on their own, but also function as monoamine oxidase inhibitors. Monoamine oxidase is an enzyme that plays a role in removing the neurotransmitters norepinephrine, serotonin, and dopamine from the brain.
You might know these as happy hormones. The inhibitors in ayahuasca block the monoamine oxidase from removing happy hormones, making more available in the brain.
Psychotria viridis contains a powerful hallucinogen called N,N-dimethyltryptamine, or DMT for short. When ingested alone, it's orally inactive, meaning this chemical doesn't create any psychedelic effect. That's because it's broken down by the monoamine oxidase in the liver and gastrointestinal tract before it crosses the blood-brain barrier.
But add in some monoamine oxidase inhibitors from the caapi, and DMT can enter the central nervous system, giving the drinker an intense and long-lasting psychedelic experience.
Ayahuasca is considered a master plant or teacher plant, which are plants that possess strong curative and spiritual powers. Other examples of teacher plants in Amazonian indigenous culture are Brunfelsia grandiflora, a flowering shrub of the nightshade family known as Shirik Sanango, Mansoa aliaceae, also known as Ajo Sasha, or garlic vine, due to its pungent garlicky scent, and Calliandra angustifolia, known as Babinzana, or the heart opener.
Ayahuasca is known as the teacher of teachers, and is said to be the voice of wisdom of all the teacher plants.
Worldwide, non-traditional interest in ayahuasca has spiked in recent decades. But because of this mainstream interest, ayahuasca is currently being investigated for use in conventional medicine. It shows promise in a number of areas, including protecting and restoring brain cells and treating a host of psychological disorders, like anxiety, depression, PTSD, and addiction. The list of potential benefits is as long as this drink's history as a traditional medicine.
Ask any Amazonian shaman, and they'll tell you the results are already in about the benefits of ayahuasca. It's a classic case of mainstream healthcare investigating a medicine that's already been used by indigenous healers for centuries. So what should we talk about next? Let me know in the comments and don't forget to subscribe for new episodes every week. Peace. We
integrate ourselves.
Hello, community. Banisteriopsis Caapi, the vine. Banisteria. I gotta think of like a banister. Banisteriopsis Caapi. Okay. And the shrub, Psychotria Viridis. Do 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 do. Boop, boop, boop.
Perfect. We don't need another.
A sense of flying. Hallucinations. And a sense of euphoria. So what happens when someone takes the ayahuasca? View the pook and the puke. Ah! The pook and the suke. Okay, ready? I'm ready. Okay. Icky. Ask any Amazonian shaman. Woo-ah! Ask Tasha the Amazon shaman.